Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to Jackson College in our spring concert celebration called Talking About My Generation. We're very excited today to have all of our performing ensembles here at JC, including the Focal Point Choir that will start us off. We'll have the Jazzy Jets, the Community Concert Band, and also the JC Drumline. Then we have some special guests joining us today. So we'll have a great time together. But without further ado, please welcome to the stage Dr. Richard Hinsey and Focal Point.
Oh.
Can we give one of applause for Vocal Point? And I know you're all wondering, when can I hear that group again? Well, you're in luck, you're gonna hear them again at about 4:30. Today, on our closer, we're gonna bring them back out to join us. Right now, taking the stage behind me, this is the Jackson College Community Concert Band, filled with community members, JC students, and the cream of the crop high school musicians in the area. This group is always recruiting. We're in a continual cycle of inviting new members. We have a few new members who are joining us for this concert. The reason I say that is we're about to start another cycle to do a concert in June, on June 18th, as part of our summer concert series, which features six performing groups. And if you have a horn and you're thinking, I just wanted to try to play again, or you play percussion, or you have a clarinet sitting there and you used to play, just know that we're going to start up rehearsals again a week from Tuesday, right in this building in the Ruth Day Theater on the other side. So just know that you're invited, and we're just very happy to share this performance with you today. We're going to tune up, and then we are going to present the Jackson Community Concert Band first set. Thank you. Talking about my generation, trying to represent popular music from many decades. We're going to go back about 100 years for some ragtime dance music. This is called Dancing into the 20s, and I'd like to introduce retired JC music professor Ron Douglas to the podium. Please welcome Ron Douglas.
Music that was taking us into the 1920s, not the 2020s, is what this music is all about. A ragtime by Saul Levy, a tango by Elizabeth Skates, both 1918, a waltz by Victor Herbert, who might be called the American waltz king in the tradition of the Viennese waltzes of Europe. And finally, the last piece by Saul Levy, I think, also 1918, is a piece that is preceding what became the Jazz Age and the Roaring Twenties. But this music from 100 years ago or more was written down, composed music. By the way, if you know how to dance the one-step, the two-step, the waltz, or the tango, dancing is not only allowed, but encouraged. Thank you.
Thank you.
I couldn't tell. Were you dancing in the aisles? Yes, excellent. The next song certainly will, and it's also a pseudo sing-along. This is called Hicksville, USA, 40 Years of Motown, and it features several songs that hopefully you've heard before. So feel free to stomp your feet and clap your hands and sing along to Hicksville, 40 Years of Motown. Thank you. Change Gears, a song called Pusta by Bonderoos Biscuits and Concert Band Classics. Category, Pusta is like a plains, open plains area where wild horses can run, and it's also celebratory music and communal music that fits very well with dancing. So hopefully you'll enjoy this change of pace. Please enjoy the second and fourth movements of Pusta.
Thank you.
Those are our soloists. Can I share this? I always miss introducing solos, so I asked if I could get help remembering. And look what I got. Isn't that wonderful? Little pictures and instruments. As you shall receive, we've got great people here. We're going to change gears again and invite the Jazzy Jets over. The majority of the Jazzy Jets are in the community concert band, so I'm going to ask them to go ahead and head on over to our seats, and we're going to play some more songs talking about my generation. As they walk by, too, I have a special announcement. Mally, walking by right now, is going to be studying music at Eastern Michigan next year. She's been accepted into college of music. Jazzy Jets, we meet on Thursdays from 3:30 to 5:30, and it's made up of college students and high school students and recent alumni of Jackson College as well, too. But I joke, and I think they think I'm joking, but I mean it. It's the best 2 hours of the week. These are just wonderful people, and we have a great time together, and they play wonderful music. And they're all trustworthy, so this is your group. If you need to hire somebody for a job, these are your people right here. They are wonderful young people. I'm going to start you off with a swing 1930s standard. This is called There Will Never Be Another You. Thank you. as we had Connor Bacon on the Barry saxophone. Tim Schneider on the trumpet. And Riley Bergen on the trumpet as well. Next, we're going to do one of the other hits off of Bruno Mars' album from 2013. This is the one that's not Uptown Funk, but it's just as exciting. This is called Treasure. Super danceable stuff. On the solo on the saxophone, Xander Mead. I have to give props to our rhythm section over here. On bass, Charlie Sexton. Drums, Colin Laney. Keyboard, Tim Thirsty. And on guitar, Tyson Walker. I'm just thinking about the next song, and I can't help but make this face. It's a Stevie Wonder classic. It is so good. And our saxophone section, so thrilled to work with this saxophone section. I hope you'll hear what we've been enjoying in rehearsals. This is Stevie Wonder's Higher Ground with the introduction by the Jazzy Jets saxophone. Thank you. saxophone solo, Brianna Patterson. We've come to a very exciting time for the jazz band. I'd like to invite Jalen Poirier and Matt Neamy to join me in featuring the amazing Jasmine Haas, one of the Teacher of the Year candidates very recently. Northwest Middle School band director Jasmine is going to play fiddle for us. Jasmine Haas, would you mind joining us on stage, please? This song needs no introduction.
This young man's song on a fiddle that's playing a hop. The devil jumped up by Henry's cup and said, "Boy, let me tell you what. You didn't know it, but I'm a fiddle player too. And if you care to take a dare, I'll make a bet with you. Now, you play a pretty good fiddle, boy, but give the devil his due. I bet the fiddle go against your soul, so I think I'm better than you." The boy said, "My name's Johnny, and it might be a sin. And I'll take that bet, you're gonna regret, because I'm the best who's ever been.
Johnny, rising up your bow, play your fiddle hard. There's no broke loose in Georgia, and the devil deals in hearts. If you win, you'll get that shiny fiddle made of gold. If you lose, the devil gets your soul."
Across the strings and made the movies. And then the band of movies was thrown again. And it sounded something like this.
Jets. At this time, we have another change of pace. Here at Jackson College, we have the JC Drumline that is made up of members who have attended and performed at the Jackson Percussion Concussion that involves, I think last year we had 12 high schools and the Detroit Lions. Honolulu Boom was right here. We'll be doing it again this coming November, so please consider yourselves invited. It is a feel-good event if there is one. And one of the nice byproducts is we get to have a fantastic drumline here, led by a member of the Honolulu Boom and Jackson native. So they are going to take the stage here, and I'm happy to introduce the JC Drumline under the direction of Jack Tallman.
Talk a little bit while he gets out. I'm going to fill time for him. My name is Jack Tallman, who's telling the truth. I am from Parma, actually, and I went to Western High School. So very proud to be able to teach in this institution in the town that I grew up in. We also have a wide range of members. We have some Jackson College students, we have some high school students, kind of from all over, some even from outside Jackson County, which is really cool. It's cool to bring so many different people together and do really partake in this activity that brings me so much joy and has given me so many opportunities to do like the Lions drumline and stuff like that. So it looks like they're ready, so I think I may let them play. I'll talk a little bit between each piece to kind of break up the pacing and keep everything moving just the way I want it. But the first tune that we're gonna play is a tune called Double Beat 2004. It was written for the Santa Clara Vanguard Drum and Bugle Corps by Murray Gussick. Please enjoy. Sometimes it's like the cavemen of the music world, but believe it or not, we have genres too, and that was actually about minimalism, believe it or not, for all my musicians out there. That one was written based on the music of Steve Glass, famous 20th century composer. Anyways, also shout out to Coleman for his little solo action at the end. The next one you're going to hear, it's pretty fast and aggressive and quick. It is one of the pieces that this group played kind of in its beginning repertoire when it was founded. Again, really fast and choppy and aggressive, and we liked it. This one is called Anaconda, and I believe it is by Dustin Schlitzer. Keeps finding its way back into our lineup. We played a lot of different music this semester through rehearsals, and we kind of settled on those two, and then the last one we're going to play for you, both through like strengths and weaknesses and finding out what we as a group are good at and trying new things. We do a lot of that over the semester. So if you're interested in learning new things, you don't even have to be a drummer, I don't really care. You can come and play with us. I will be around after this, but know that the drumline is a class that runs in the fall and the spring through the college. And with enough interest, we could even run over the summer. At that, I might be swinging a surprising band right now, but who knows? We'll talk about it and figure it out. I think it's a really, really great ensemble, and I'm so proud that it exists in this community, in the greater Jackson area. So again, if you or anyone you know would be interested, please come talk to me about it. I would love to chat with you about drums and the Jackson College drumline. This last one that you're going to hear is called Latin Lover. It was written for the Cavaliers Drum and Bugle Corps in 2007 by a man named Brian Perez. And it's my favorite piece of drumline literature out there. Once again, we're the Jackson College Drumline. Thank you so much for being here. I hope that you've enjoyed the concert thus far and the rest of the set.
All invited to audition for the drumline. It's a very well-run group. They meet on Monday nights to accommodate people's schedules. So let's change gears again. That's what this concert's all about. We're now going to have the second set of the Community Concert Band, and I'd like to introduce a prolific composer in this area who's going to come up and talk about the next piece. Please welcome to the microphone and the podium, Mr. Chris Haas.
Hello, I am so excited to be joining you guys today. It always means so much when Dan and the band lets me wave my hands on stage, so this is going to be a lot of fun. The next piece we'll be doing is quite special. This is a completely new composition, actually by a composition student of mine, whose name is Tim. And Tim is actually in the audience. I don't know if it's possible to get the house lights on so Tim can stand up. Yeah, Tim, yeah! Thank you, lighting team. Tim has been doing fantastic music, and I feel so thankful and spoiled that I get to nudge him into adding way too many dynamics into his music, like I always do. But as he was showing me sketches of this piece, I kept thinking, man, this would be such a blast with the Jackson Band. And I talked to Dan about it, and him being the enthusiastic, open-minded guy that he is, gave me the thumbs up immediately. So we get to play it today. And musically, the piece is quite cinematic and exciting. It's meant to be influenced by video game music. I know Tim cites the game Oblivion as being one of the main OSTs that influenced the music behind this. That game is quite high fantasy, exciting, epic, going on quests and stuff like that, and I think you can definitely sense that in the music. We kind of navigate between a few sections in this piece. So we begin kind of setting the tone, setting the stakes of this quest, and then go into this kind of hazy section that Tim labeled the ominous cave. So just tension and anxiety in this kind of new space. And then we go into the battle, so that's quite intense and bombastic, and then that leads to almost like an elegy, this sad, solemn piece that maybe is to the people who passed in that battle. And then we end on a high note with kind of the conquest, with the dominion of the piece, epically and excitingly. So I thank you all so much. I hope you all enjoy the piece.
Thank you.
Thank you for the great piece, Mr. Howard. You did a great job preparing it and getting it ready. And how about a hand for Chris Haas as well? I'd like to introduce MSBOA Director Emeritus, former director of the Vandercook Lake Bands and the Western High School Bands, recently retired, and we're thrilled to have him back with our band today. He's going to take the podium and introduce you to a piece called Third Sweep. Please welcome Paul Bickle.
Hi. Hi, I'm Paul. I'm Dan's older brother, and I'm glad he let me conduct a piece today. As I said, I'm a retired band director. I just have two things to tell you. First, how immensely proud I am of my brother and what he has done here at Jackson College. I think he needs a lot of recognition for what he does. And secondly, this piece, Third Sweep, is a band piece. It is a masterwork. It's been around for over 50 years, and it has one thing that's a little weird. It has weird time signatures. It has a march that has too many beats, five beats. And you realize they took the beat and took it away from the second movement, which is a waltz that has sometimes only two beats per measure. Only music people know what I'm talking about, and that's okay. But the part is that there are three movements, so when I get done conducting the first piece, do not clap. I will not take it personally. When the second piece ends, do not clap. I will not take it personally. I will only take it personally if you do not clap after the third song. So enjoy the Jackson Concert Band, Third Sweep by Jacob. Thank you.
known my whole life. You can't talk about Generations without talking about Disney and the music of Disney. And this was requested by one of our clarinet players, who is going to be working for Disney World this summer. Kenson Fall, will you stand up and take a round of applause? Feel free to sing along. I'm sure you'll know a few of these. This is called Disney at the Oscars. you heard any of those? A couple of them pretty well known. Very excited to bring Vocal Point back out to the stage, as well as members of the Jazzy Jets rhythm section. And we're happy to feature members of the band Flight. We have on the guitar, J.D. Boone. And singing for us today in our British influences is Scott Moran. Make sure you're ready. At the end of this, we're going to ask you to sing along for a little bit as well, too. Very excited to present to you British Influence.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jason Drumline.